السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. This lecture discussed an anxiety, which is a normal protective psychological response to an unpleasant or a threatening situation. The term an anxiety disorder encompasses a variety of conditions which can either exist on their own or in conjugation with other psychiatric or physical illnesses. Depression is the most common comorbidity associated with the anxiety, followed by alcohol and substance use disorder. Anxiety disorders are broadly divided into many categories, and these categories involve the following. Generalized anxiety disorders, أو القلق المستمر, characterized by excessive, exaggerated anxiety and worry about everyday life events with no obvious reason for worry. Panic disorders, اضطرابات أو نوبات الهلع, a sudden episodes of intense fear that trigger severe physical reaction when there is no danger or apparent cause. Social anxiety disorders or the social phobia, الخوف من الوقوف أمام الناس أو الجمهور, which involve intense anxiety or fear of being judged, negatively evaluated or rejected in a social or performance situation. Specific phobia, including phonophobia, photophobia, agoraphobia, and others, which is classified under the umbrella of anxiety disorders. Separation anxiety disorders, most commonly seen in individuals, or the individuals experience excessive anxiety regarding separation from the home or from people to whom the individual has a strong emotional attachment, especially the parents and the caregivers. نشوف أكثر شيء بالأشخاص اللي هم يقضون معظم عمرهم بمكان معين وعلى غفلة ينتقلون لمكان آخر, أو الأشخاص اللي يفقدون شخص عزيز عليهم, خصوصا إذا كان أكو هنالك strong emotional attachment with the specific person. Also we have illness and anxiety disorders اللي هي تسمى الـ health anxiety أو hypochondriasis. هذا النوع الشخص, هذا النوع الأشخاص المصابين بهذا النوع راح يدعون أن هم على وشك الإصابة بمرض معين أو هم فعلا أصيبوا بهذا المرض, وأي أعراض تظهر عليهم راح ينسبوها لهذا المرض. نقدر نشوفه حاليا أكو أشخاص اللي إذا صار عندهم mild throat discomfort with a dry cough for short period, راس راح يقول لك أنا أصبت بالكورونا فيروس. Also, we have post-traumatic stress disorder and obsessive-compulsive disorders that were previously classified under the umbrella of the anxiety disorder, but now are considered to be separated health illnesses. اللي حاليا تحولت من anxiety disorders إلى mental health disorders. Post-traumatic stress disorder, which is a mental health condition that triggers by a terrifying events. هنا الشخص المصاب بالبوست تروماتيك ستريس راح يصاب بهذا النوع من المنتال هيلث ديسوردرز بعد ما يتعرض الى حادث مروع, خلينا نقول يتعرض الى حادث سياره مروع او كان شاهد على هذا الحادث. هذا الحادث راح يكون اللي هو تريجر فور ديفلوبمنت اوف ذا بوست تروماتيك ستريس ديسوردرز. بينما الاوبسيسيف كومبلسيف ديسوردر المعروف بالوسواس القهري, اللي هو أيضا mental health disorder in which the person feels the need to perform certain routine repeatedly, إحنا نسميها compulsion, or has certain thought repeatedly, اللي هو obsessive أو obsession. كمثال عليها, كمثال على compulsion أو certain routine that perform certain routine repeatedly, إنه الشخص بخمس دقائق راح يغسل إيده 20 أو 30 مرة, يظل عنده وسواس قهري غسل انه اذا ما نظفت غسل من غسل اول مره ينشف بالخاوي يقول لك لا الخاوي وسخ, يرجع يغسل مره ثانيه, يقول لك لزمت المغسل, المغسله وسخه, يغسل مره ثالثه, الحنفيه وسخه, الباب وسخ, وهكذا فتره كلش قصيره, خلينا نقول خمس دقائق هو مغسل ايده 20 او 30 مره. بينما الاوبسيشن اللي هي ريبيتد ثوت, ريبيتد ثوت اور ذا ثوت اكر ريبيتدلي, خلينا نقول فيميل ورا ما تخلص الطبخ تطفي الطباخ تروح للغرفه, بتوصل للغرفه تجيها افكار انه الطباخ بعدها مشتغل, فترجع تتأكد مرة تلقاها طافي, ترجع للغرفة ترجع لها الأفكار, تروح مرة ثانية ومرة ثالثة ومرة رابعة, خلينا نقول خلال خمس دقائق أيضا تروح على الطباخ تشوفها 20 أو 30 مرة وهكذا. فهذا الوسواس القهري اللي يندرج ضمن المنتال هيلث ديسوردرز. هنا بهاي المحاضرة راح نركز على ثلاث أنواع, الجنرالايز أنكزايتي ديسوردر, البانيك ديسوردرز, أند سوشيال أنكزايتي ديسوردرز. Etiology of the anxiety disorders include both genetics and the psychosocial factors, اللي هي stressful environmental factors, which play an important role in development of different of anxiety disorders in susceptible individuals. It has been reported that those experience one or more negative life events will have a threefold increase chance of developing GAD, generalized anxiety disorders, as well as panic disorders. فاي ستريسفول ايفنتس يتعرضها الشخص اللي عنده جينيتك بريديسبوزيشن فور ذا ديفلوبمنت اوف انكزايتي ديس اوردرز ويل بلاي ان امبورتنت اور انكريز ذا تشانس فور ديفلوبينج اوف سوتش كونديشن. The pathophysiology of anxiety disorder. Anxiety occurs when there is a disturbance of the arousal system in the brain. والarousal system أو الarousal مقصود بها physiological and psychological state of being awoken. يعني السيستم المسؤول على بقاء الشخص متيقظ أو متنبه أو صاحي. Arousal is maintained by at least of three interconnected systems. A general arousal system, an emotional arousal system, an endocrine autocrine arousal system. Excessive activity of the general arousal system due to internal or external stresses, نحن قلناها life events or environmental stressful events, can lead to a state of hyperarousal as seen in anxiety. دائما الشخص اللي عنده anxiety ما أخذيها سابقا انه يعاني من الانسومنيا، يكون دائما صاحي ومتيقظ ما يقدر ينام ساعة 11 او 12 بالليل، يتأخر نومته لي ساعة 2 او 3 او 4 الفجر، يعني عنده الارازل سيستم يكون كلش متيقظ او متنبه او يكون عالي. Emotional aspects of the arousal such as fear and anxiety are contributed by the limbic system which also serve to focus attention on selected aspects of the environment. There is evidence that increased activity in certain limbic pathway with limbic. These arousal system activate physical response to arousal such as increased muscle tone, increased sympathetic activity, and increased output of the anterior and posterior pituitary hormones. Inappropriate increase in the anatomic increase in the autonomic activity are often associated with the anxiety state, and the resulting symptoms include palpitation, sweating, tremor, and others may initiate a vesicular cycles that increase the anxiety. While most common symptoms associated with the activation of the arousal system or the anxiety disorder in general. Several neurotransmitters that have been implicated in the arousal system, acetylcholine is the main transmitters that maintain general arousal, but there is evidence that is heightened emotional arousal that is particularly associated with the noradrenergic and the serotonergic activity. وهذا احنا نركز عليها as the drugs that which antagonize such activity have an anxiolytic effect. In addition, the inhibitory neurotransmitters gamma aminobutyric acid exert an inhibitory control on the other transmitters pathways. And increased GABA activity may have a protective effect against excessive stress reaction. Many of these drugs increase the GABA activity, and the most important one is the benzodiazepine that most commonly used in the treatment of different anxiety disorders because these agents are having potent anxiolytics. فهنا بالتريتمنت راح نركز على الانتيدبريسنت because it antagonize or suppress the uptake of the serotonin and norepinephrine in addition to benzodiazepine which have an increased the activity of GABA. هسه راح ندخل على نوع من الانكزايتي بهاي المحاضره. اول نوع راح نركز على generalized anxiety disorders. General anxiety disorders هي القلق المستمر اللي هو الشخص راح يعاني من القلق تجاه كل شيء بالحياة اليومية، من مال، من عمل، من صحة، من عائلة، من علاقات اجتماعية. هذا النوع من القلق راح يتميز بأنه كونه مفرط وأكثر من الطبيعي وغير منطقي وبدون غير منطقي أو بدون سبب. فهنا general anxiety disorders usually typically onset occur in the early adulthood. The symptoms اللي راح ركز عليها excessive anxiety or worry لكنها قلق مفرط أكثر من الطبيعي. Involve multiple events in daily life or activities that occurring more day for at least 6 months. قلق مفرط excessive anxiety or worry بدون سبب يظهر معظم الأيام ولفترة ما لا تقل عن 6 شهور. بالإضافة القلق المفرط اللي هو أكثر الأيام تظهر بأكثر من 6 شهور. Anxiety and worry associated with at least 3 of the following symptoms اللي تنقسم somatic symptoms and the psychic symptoms. somatic الجسدي أو الجسمي والسايكيك الذهني الأعراض الذهنية والأعراض الجسدية. الأعراض الذهنية تشمل السايكيك symptoms include restlessness, easy fatigue, poor concentration or mind going blank and irritability. While the somatic symptoms أو الأعراض الجسدية راح تتضمن muscle tension, insomnia or unsatisfying sleep بالإضافة إلى الـ GIT disorders اللي هي most common irritable bowel syndrome. Then anxiety or worry causing significant distress or functional impairment and is not attributable to another substance, medical or psychiatric condition. هاي تدخل ضمن differential diagnosis of generalized anxiety disorders. Desired outcome and the goal of therapy for the generalized anxiety disorders are to acutely reduce the severity and the duration of the anxiety symptoms and to restore overall functioning. Long-term goal is to achieve and maintain remission. Patient with the GAD may be managed with both psychotherapy, non-pharmacological therapy, pharmacotherapy, or both, depending on the severity of the condition. Those with the severe symptoms resulting in functional impairment should receive anti-anxiety medication. Non-pharmacological therapy for generalized anxiety disorders involves psychoeducation, exercise, stress management, and the psychotherapy. Psychoeducation should provide information on the GAD and its management to the patient. Patient should be instructed to avoid stimulant agents, especially caffeine, decongestant, diet pills اللي تستخدم حبوب المنحفة, and excessive alcohol use. Regular exercise is also recommended or strongly recommended for any subjects with any type of anxiety, even for the normal population. Cognitive behavioral therapy, العلاج المعرفي السلوكي, is the most effective psychological therapy for the patient with the GAD. والعلاج cognitive behavioral therapy is the changing perception, اللي هو change the thought of the patient will lead to change the behaviors and the emotion of the patient. فهنا احنا قلناها direct interview with the patient, اشرح له على المرض, احاول اغير الافكار السلبية اللي عند المريض المصاب بالgeneralized anxiety disorders في سبيل انه حسن من حالته, وحاول يقلل او يقضي او يقضي على او يصير عنده control على الcondition او anxiety اللي هي بتكون مستمرة بشكل يومي. Treatment with again with the CPT may be maintained for up to 1 year. Pharmacological therapy involves the following: antidepressants, which is drug of choice for the treatment of the GAD because of tolerable side effect profile, no risk for dependency, and efficacy in common comorbid condition, including depression, panic, obsessive compulsive disorder, and the social anxiety disorders. So now antidepressant drug of choice for different types of anxiety. In addition to antidepressants, we have benzodiazepines that remain the most effective and commonly used treatment for short-term management of anxiety when immediate relief of symptoms is desired. They also recommended for intermittent or adjunctive use during the GAD exacerbation or for sleep disturbance during the initiation of antidepressants treatment. Buspirone can also be used, regabalin, which are alternative agents for patients with the GAD without depression. Hydroxyzine, usually adjunctive, and is less desirable for long-term treatment because of the its side effect. Antidepressants, drug of choice, which can effectively reduce the psychic symptoms, worry, and apprehension of the anxiety, in addition with the modest effect on the autonomic or the somatic symptoms, tremor, rapid heart rate, and the sweating. فهنا راح الانتيدبريسنت فيرست لاين تريتمنت, لانه سيطر لي على السايكيك سيمتومز بالاعراض الذهنيه بالاضافه للسوماتيك سيمتومز الاعراض الجسديه المتعلقه بالجنرالايز انكزايتي ديس اوردرز. All antidepressants evaluated to provide similar degree of anxiety reduction. The onset of anti-anxiety effect usually delayed by 2 to 4 weeks. هنا نبه المريض انه مو راسا راح تستجيب للعلاج اول يوم او ثاني او ثالث يوم. بعد فترة بعد ايام او هي اسبوعين لاربع اسابيع راح تشوف اكو تحسن بحالتك. فهنا يا اما ننبه المريض على هاي النقطة او ننطي البنزوديازيبين خلال هاي الفترة concomitantly with the antidepressants بنفس الوقت تبديها اثنيناتهم الى ان يصير كنترول بالانتيدبريسنس, نسوي تابرنج او تابرنج ديسك او جراديوال ديسكونتينيويشن اوف بنزوديازيبين. سيلكتيف سيروتونين ري ابتيك انهبيتر, سيلكتيف سيروتونين نور ابينفرين ري ابتيك انهبيترز ار يوجوالي بريفيرد اوفر ذا ترايسايكلينج انتيدبريسنس بيكوز اوف ذا امبروف سيفتي اند تولرابيلتي فور ذا تريتمنت اوف ديفرنت تايب اوف انكزايتي. antidepressants modulate the synaptic 5-HT, serotonin, norepinephrine, and or dopamine reuptake, and the receptors activated in neuronal signal transduction. These intracellular changes modify the expression of the genes and the protein which are important in stress response, including glucocorticoid receptors, brain-derived neurotrophic factors, and corticotropin-releasing hormones. We have said that there is a relationship between stress, level of cortisol, and stress. Activation of these stress-adapting pathways may improve both somatic and the psychic symptoms of anxiety. Serotonin, norepinephrine reuptake inhibitors, including venlafaxine and duloxetine, that is approved by the FDA for the treatment of the GAD, it is elevate anxiety with or without depression and have improved tolerability over the TCA. Venlafaxine effective at doses of 75 to 225 mg per day and maintain response with extended treatment. It is also effective for GAD in children and adolescents. The most common side effects reported with the GAD include nausea, somnolence, dry mouth, dizziness, sweating, constipation, and anorexia. Duloxetine have similar effectiveness and the safety profile to that of the venlafaxine. Selective serotonin reuptake inhibitors, paroxetine, escitalopram, and sertraline, that have been shown to be significantly more effective than a placebo in reducing the anxiety symptoms in adults with the GAD. Common side effects include somnolence, headache, nausea, dry mouth, diarrhea, sweating, and sexual abnormalities. Tricyclic antidepressants, emipramine treatment of the GAD result in higher rate of remission of anxiety symptoms than the treatment with the trazodone and diazepam, and both emipramine and trazodone more effective than diazepam or a placebo in reducing psychic symptoms of anxiety. These are limited by the bothersome adverse effect, sedation, orthostatic hypotension, anticholinergic effect, and weight gain. Benzodiazepine, which are recommended for acute treatment of GAD when short-term relief is needed as an adjunctive during initiation of antidepressant therapy or to improve the sleep. More effective for the somatic symptoms, like in the muscle tension, insomnia, with GIT abnormalities, than more effective for the somatic symptoms than for the psychic symptoms. Major benzodiazepine disadvantage are lack of the effectiveness for depression. In addition to that, risk of the dependency and abuse and potential interdose rebound and anxiety, especially with the short-acting benzodiazepine, should be avoided in older adults and patients with the current or past chemical dependency. Benzodiazepine act through the enhancement or enhancing the transmission of the inhibitory neurotransmitters GABA through the interaction with the GABA-A receptors complex. Most common side effects of benzodiazepine include CNS depressive effect and the cognitive effect. Discontinuation, نقطه مهمه, discontinuation of benzodiazepine may be associated with withdrawal, rebound, and anxiety, and high rate of relapse, especially when higher doses of benzodiazepine and longer duration of therapy used, which increase the severity of the withdrawal and risk seizures after the abrupt or rapid discontinuation. While the patient should be gradually tapering the dose of or the benzodiazepine use over a period of several weeks or month to avoid withdrawal symptoms. مقطع حراسة لازم أسوي أقل الجرعة خلال عدة أسابيع لعدة أشهر حتى أمنع ظهور withdrawal symptoms. Pregabalin is a calcium channel modulator and its anxiolytic properties are attributed to its selective binding to the alpha 2 delta subunit of the voltage-gated calcium channels. Is effective for both somatic and psychic symptoms of anxiety with the onset of effects similar to the alprazolam. It should be used cautionally in patients with current or past history of substance abuse. Hydroxyzine as an alternative agent, which is effective for the acute reduction of the somatic symptoms of anxiety but not for the psychic features of anxiety, depression, and other common comorbid anxiety. Paspiron 5-HT1A partial agonist is thought to exert an anxiolytic effect by reducing presynaptic 5-HT firing. It has a gradual onset of action for 2 weeks to get adequate or the full response or full anxiolytic effect and does not provide immediate anxiety relief. Buspirone is well tolerated and does not cause sedation. The most common adverse effects including dizziness, nausea, and headache. Second generation antipsychotic, quetiapine, olanzapine, and risperidone have demonstrated benefit in the generalized anxiety disorders. Risperidone and olanzapine may improve treatment outcome in patients with inadequate response to initial pharmacotherapy. Second generation associated with the risk of the weight gain, sedation, fatigue, and extrapyramidal side effect. النوع الثاني من الـ anxiety disorders in this بهاي المحاضرة including the panic disorders احنا قلناها اضطرابات الهلع او نوبات الهلع. هنا الشخص راح يصاب او عنده شعور بالخوف الشديد او القلق الامر ما على وشك الحصول. لو ناخذ example عليها انه شخص صعد بمصعد واثناء ما هو داخل المصعد طفت الكهرباء، هنا المصعد وقف المصعد، وحده بالمصعد، المصعد مظلم ويبقى محصور بالمصعد لمده عده ساعات، هاي هنا راح تكون تريجر فاكتورز او ستريسفول انفيرمنتال فاكتورز، خصوصا اذا الشخص كان عنده جينيتيك بريديسبوزيشن فور ديفلوبينج اوف انكزايتي، فهنا صارت عنده البانيك اتاك. هذا الشخص مستقبلا من تقول له او من تدعيه على مكان، هذا المكان يكون مثلا الطابق الخامس او السادس، من راح يفكر انه اكو مصعد ولازم اصعد به يفوق راح يبدي يتجنب هذا المصعد، راح يصير عنده الشعور الخوف الشديد او القلق مجرد التفكير انه راح يصعد للطابق الخامس بالمصعد، فهنا يا اما ما يروح او دائما يتجنب المصعد ويستخدم السلم بالصعود. So panic disorders typically presents in late adolescence or early adulthood. Most common symptoms associated with this type of disorder include a panic attack, يعني هنقول نوبة خوف, panic attack that is an abrupt surge of intense fear, زيادة أو الشعور بالخوف الشديد, or discomfort that is peaking within a minute. هذا الشعور بالخوف الشديد راح يوصل البيك مالته اكثر شيء خلال 10 دقائق الى 20 دقيقه ويظل مستمر لعده ساعات. فهنا الشخص اللي عنده بانيك اتاك مجرد التفكير بموضوع معين صارت له سابقا صار به مجرد التفكير راح يؤدي الى سيرج انتينس فير سيرج ابربت سيرج اوف انتينس فير اور ديسكمفورت ذات بيكن وذن مينيتس. بالاضافه الى الشعور الشديد الشعور بالخوف الشديد اكو عندي 4 or more of the following symptoms associated with this intense fear: palpitation or rapid heart rate, sweating, trembling or shaking, sensation of shortness of breath, feeling of choking, chest pain or discomfort, nausea or abdominal distress, feeling dizzy or lightheadedness, chills or hot flashes, paresthesias, fear of dying, fear of losing control of going crazy. At least one of the attacks has been followed by 1 month of or more of one or both of the following: persistence concern or worry about additional attacks. مجرد التفكير انه راح يروح نفس على اللي صار سابقا راح يؤدي الى concern worry about additional attack and significant maladaptive changes in behaviors related to the attacks. For example, avoidance. فهذا الشخص اللي خايفه من المصعد اللي صارت له البانيك اتاك عندما كان بالمصعد طفت الكهرباء مجرد التفكير انه راح يروح مكان موجود بالطابق الخامس او السادس باستعمال المصعد هنا وحده من اثنين يا اما يصير عنده الاتاك البانيك اتاك او اصلا يتجنب هذا الشيء يتجنب الذهاب للموعد اللي محددين له اللي هو بالطابق الخامس او السادس أو يروح ويستخدم يتجنب المصعد ويستخدم الدرج. The main objective of a treatment are to reduce the severity and the frequency of the panic attack, reduce anticipatory anxiety and agoraphobic behaviors, and minimize the symptoms of depression or other comorbid disorders. Long-term goal is to achieve and sustain remission and restore overall functioning. Treatment option including medication, psychotherapy, or combination of both. Patient with the panic symptoms without agoraphobia. والagoraphobia اللي هو رهاب الأماكن المزدحمة مثل القاعات الكبيرة المزدحمة بالناس أو المراكز التجارية المزدحمة. So patient with panic symptoms without agoraphobia may respond to pharmacotherapy. Agoraphobic symptoms generally take longer to respond than the panic symptoms. The acute phase of the panic disorders treatment lasts about 12 weeks and should be markedly reduced or eliminate panic attacks and minimize anticipatory anxiety and phobic avoidance. فهنا أنا حتى أحصل الـ complete resolution of the symptoms with antidepressant drugs لازم أنتظر 12 أسبوع حتى أحصل الـ complete resolution أو الـ peak effect of such agents. هنا أيضا نبه المريض على هاي النقطة أنه ما راح تحصل response to treatment بيوم أو يومين أو ثلاثة، لازم تنتظر عدة أسابيع حتى يظهر عندك الـ complete resolution وتستفاد الاستفادة القصوى من الـ treatment. هاي واحدة. النقطة الثانية treatment should be continued to prevent relapse for additional 12 to 18 months before attempting discontinuation. فهنا عندي rate of relapse كلش عالي خلال إذا قطعت الـ treatment. فهنا بعد ما يكون عندي complete resolution of the symptoms لازم أنتظر من سنة إلى سنة ونص before attempting discontinuation. A patient with the PD should avoid the stimulant agents, especially decongestant, diet pills, and caffeine, which precipitate a panic attack. CBT also generally include psychoeducation, self-monitoring, countering anxious belief, exposure to fear cue, and modification of anxiety-maintaining behaviors. While exposure therapy احنا نركز عليه is useful in the patient with the phobic avoidance. CBT is considered first line treatment of the PD patient where efficacy similar to that of the pharmacotherapy. وأيضا CBT هنا يضمن لي الأور إكسبوجر ثيرابي هو بارت من CBT. دائما نحاول المريض نعرضه للمواقف اللي هو يخاف من عندها في سبيل أنه نقضي على الأفكار السلبية اللي صايرة عند المريض تجاه موقف معين. Pharmacological therapy include the use of the different type of antidepressants in addition to benzodiazepine. Antidepressants typically require 4 weeks for the onset of anti-panic effects, 4 أسابيع حتى تظهر الإفكتس with optimal response as 6 to 12 weeks. أيضا نبه المريض أنه ما راح تحصل complete resolution of your symptoms. لازم تنتظر عدة أسابيع حتى تظهر عندك حتى تتحسن حالتك أو بنفس الوقت ننطي بنفس الوقت بنزوديازيبين ويا الأنتي ديبريسنت أيجنس حتى في سبيل أنه أزيد الريكفري أو أنتظر أو أحاول أغطي على السيمبتومز اللي تظهر للمريض إلى أن يشتغل أنتي ديبريسنت. Treatment with amipramine leaves 45 to 70% of the patient panic free. Disopyramine and clomipramine also effective. However, TCA considered to be second or third line pharmacotherapy because of the poorer tolerability and toxicity on the overdose. Selective serotonin reuptake inhibitor, which is a drug of choice for patients with the panic disorders. فهنا دائما نركز عليها selective serotonin reuptake inhibitors. Serotonin norepinephrine reuptake inhibitors with lefaxine also useful agents at a dose of 75 to 225 mg that reduce panic and anticipatory anxiety in short-term control trial and prevent relapse with extended treatment over the 6 months. Monoamine oxidase inhibitors are reserved for patients who are refractory to others' treatment. بعد patient اللي ما يستجيب لل selective serotonin reuptake inhibitor, selective serotonin norepinephrine inhibitors و tricyclic depressant antidepressants هنا راح نعطي monoamine oxidase inhibitors وهذا بسبب انه الاجنس monoamine oxidase inhibitor agents may have significant side effect that limit adherence. Additional patient must adhere to dietary restriction of tyramine and avoid sympathomimetic drugs to avoid hypertensive crisis. Monoamine oxidase inhibitory having a severe drug-drug interaction, drug-food interaction with the severe adverse profile lead to reduce adherence to such agents. فدائما يخلوها آخر line للrefractory patient to other treatment. Benzodiazepine also effective anti-panic agents with significant effect on the anticipatory anxiety and the phobic behaviors. أيضا البيتا بلوكر بندلول 25 ملغ 3 times a day is an effective adjunctive treatment with the selective serotonin reuptake inhibitors. Propranolol has been found to be equivalent to alprazolam in reducing the panic attack. Beta blocker not expected to reduce the psychic anxiety or avoidance behaviors. فقط هنا عندي control some symptoms associated with the anxiety اللي هي tremor, palpitation, sweating, and some other type of the symptoms. النوع الثالث من الانكزايتي ديسوردرز بهاي المحاضره اللي هو سوشيال انكزايتي ديسوردرز، اللي احنا نعرفها بالسوشيال فوبيا، الخوف الشديد من مواجهه الناس او الوقوف امام الناس. اكثر شيء نشوفه بالاشخاص اللي عندهم برزنتيشن او عندهم سيمينار او عندهم مؤتمر او ندوه، تشوف هذول الناس دائما يتجنبون الوقوف امام الناس او امام الجمهور، او يتجنبون التحدث امام الناس، وكان الناس يعني عدد قليل او كثير، يعني حتى تدخل منها ضمن العزايم، العزيم الشخص يعزمه على الغداء او العشاء قاعدين وياه 6-7 اشخاص او 10 اشخاص، تشوفه دائما ساكت وما يتكلم او ما يشاركهم بالحديث. هذا الشخص دائما يعاني من السوشيال فوبيا، سوشيال فوبيا which is a chronic disorder that is begins in adolescence. هنا هذول الأشخاص طبعاً جاهدين على تجنب الأشياء اللي يخشوها، اللي قلناها الوقوف أمام الناس، أيضاً ما عندهم قدرة على إيقاف الشعور بالخوف، وعندهم تفكير دائماً أنه يشعرون بالخوف، وأنه هذول الناس اللي ما قابلهم دائماً راح تقييمهم يكون سلبي تجاه البرزنتيشن خلينا نقول، أو أيضاً مناقشتهم راح تكون سلبية، أو ما راح يوصلون الفكرة اللي هم يريدون يوصلوها للناس. هاي معتقداتهم، عليه كل هالمعتقدات راح تؤدي إنه الشخص يعزل نفسه، ما يختلط بالناس أو ما يقف قدام الناس، ودائما يخلي الآخرين هم اللي يأخذون مكانه، وعليه راح تأثر على حياته الاجتماعية والأعراض الأخرى اللي راح نشوفها بعد شوية. Individuals that have marked fear or anxiety about one or more social situation where they are exposed to possible scrutiny or negative evaluation. دائما حاطة بباله انه اكو تقييم سلبي للبرزنتيشن او السيمينار مالته. Such condition include common social interaction, conversation, eating, drinking or performing. Social anxiety disorder differ from a specific phobia in which the fear and anxiety are limited to particular objects or situation. محدوده يعني مواقف معينه او اوبجكتس معينه. In children, the anxiety must be present in the peer setting, not just in the interaction, not just in interactions with the adults. Symptoms most commonly associated with the social anxiety disorders, the individual's fear acting in a way of showing or showing anxiety that will be negatively evaluated. Including humiliating or embarrassing or lead to rejection or offend others. Also social situation almost always provoke fear or anxiety and are avoided or endured with intense fear or anxiety. Children also express fear and anxiety by different way from that of the adults by crying, traumas, الغضب أو انفعالات الغضب. Freezing, cleaning, دائما تشوفه ملتصق بأبوه أو بأمه. Or failing to speak in a social situation, دائما يتكلم بالبيت يتكلم من يجي شخص غريب يحكي وياه يسكت، يفقد القدرة على الكلام أو ما يعرف شلون يعبر بالكلام. Fear or anxiety is persistent, typically lasting for 6 months or more. Causes clinically significant distress or impairment in social, occupational, and other area of functioning not attributable to physiological effects or substance or another medical condition, and not better explained by symptoms of another mental disorders, including panic disorders, body dysphoric disorders, and autism spectrum disorders. Goal of a treatment. Of acute treatment of the panic disorders is to reduce the physiological symptoms of anxiety, fear of the social situation, and phobic behaviors. The long-term goal is to restore social functioning and improve patient quality of life. Patients with the SAD usually managed with the pharmacotherapy or the psychotherapy. Children with the SAD should be offered psychotherapy and not pharmacological therapy first. However, many patients will not achieve a full response. Non-pharmacological therapy involves patient education on the disease course, treatment option, and expectation, which is essential for such patient and condition. CBT that target avoidance, learning, and negative thinking patterns associated with the social anxiety. CBT is effective for reducing anxiety and phobic avoidance and lead to a greater likelihood of maintaining response after treatment discontinuation than does the pharmacotherapy. Pharmacotherapy involves the antidepressant selective serotonin reuptake inhibitors, which is a drug of choice for the patient with the social and anxiety disorders, depending on the tolerability and efficacy for the SAD and comorbid depression of presence. Onset of response for antidepressants may be as long as 8 to 12 weeks. أيضا ننبه المريض أنه complete resolution will be occurs after several weeks after initiation of the therapy. فأنت تأخذ علاجك وأنت تتوقع أنه أكو استجابة. لازم الاستجابة تتأخر كذا أسبوع حتى تشوف complete resolution of your symptoms. Also, patient responding to medication should be continued to treatment for at least 1 year. فنبه هذا المريض أنه علاجك الأعراض راح تختفي خلال عدة أسابيع ورا ما تبدي بالتريتمنت. والتريتمنت مالتك لازم تستمر عليه أقل شيء لمدة سنة، مو أنه راحت السيمبتومز أقطع علاجي، لا راحت السيمبتومز أنا استمر عليه لمدة سنة. Many patients relapse when medication is discontinued and there are no clear prediction factors for who will maintain response. Some patients may elect more long-term treatment أكثر من سنة owing to the fear of relapse. Selective serotonin and selective norepinephrine reuptake inhibitors improve the social anxiety and phobic avoidance and reduce overall disability, which is the treatment of choice for such condition. Monoamine oxidase inhibitors and reversible inhibitory of monoamine oxidase, which is generally reserved for the treatment refractory patient. الأشخاص اللي ما يستجيبون للselective serotonin reuptake inhibitor selective serotonin norepinephrine reuptake inhibitors should be treated with the monoamine oxidase inhibitory agents. This is because dietary restriction, drug interaction, and the side effect profile of monoamine oxidase inhibitory agents. Benzodiazepine are used commonly in SAD, however limited data support their use. فهنا دائما benzodiazepine ما ينصح باستخدامها باللي عندهم social and anxiety disorders. Anticonvulsant including gabapentin and pregabalin, structurally similar anticonvulsant that have each demonstrated modest benefits, and they should be considered for the patient with inadequate response to antidepressants, selective serotonin reuptake inhibitors, and selective serotonin norepinephrine reuptake inhibitors. Beta blockers, وهذا اللي احنا نركز عليه. Beta blocker decrease the physiological symptoms of anxiety. Physiological symptoms of anxiety and the useful for reducing performance and anxiety. أي شخص وهاي خلوها ببالكم، أي شخص يعاني من السوشيال فوبيا وعنده برزنتيشن ويخاف يوقف قدام الناس أو قدام الجمهور، دائما ننصحه تاخذ أنديرال اللي هو بروبرانولول 20-40 ملغ administers 1 hour before the performance situation. يكون كلش كافي حتى يسيطر على الاعراض الفيزيولوجيكال سيمتومز المصاحبه للسوشيال فوبيا اللي هي التريمر البالبيتيشن السويتينجز اند اذر سم اذر سيمتومز اللي هي الفيزيولوجيكال سيمتومز يكون بها ادكويت كنترول وذ بروبرانولول ات دوز اوف 20 تو 40 ملغ. فاي شخص يخاف ينطي البرزنتيشن او السيمينار او يشارك بمؤتمر خليه ياخذ انديرال 20 ملغ او 40 ملغ قبل ساعة من الـ before performance situation. طبعا نخلي بان الكونتر انديكيشن والكونتر انديكيشن تو بيتا بلوكرز من الاسما من الدايبيتس مليتاس and other condition. However, beta blocker are not useful in SAD. طبعا هو ما يستخدم treatment للsocial anxiety disorder لكنه القدرة على القدرة على التحكم او السيطرة على physiological symptoms associated with the SAD. And thank you.